Oop. And we're back. I'm still annoyed about how things ended last time, but we're going. So, with Atlas, you know... Atlas running amok, we gotta contact in order to try and get to the vault. Or, you know, a vault with all of Atlas's major equipment. And we got a lot of guys to get through. Jesus Christ.
Hey, are you attempting stealth? It is this what stealth looks like. You're on camera, by the way, and this is the first non-rerun that we've all seen in like 14 years. Chaz and the chili cheese fries. Hey, I'm not into him. No way.
Hold on, sorry, I'm trying to listen to Shank, but...
And if you're looking for the girl, I can assure you she is unharmed. Shit, not that we wouldn't, I mean, we'd totally harm her. I'm thinking of harming her right now. Maybe Chaz will come too.
I'm now only starting to realize... I'm dead. I'm now only starting to realize, you know... Moxie made the joke just like, oh, it's the guy stabbing arena. But I'm now noticing, like, all the, everyone, like, you know, with batons and, you know, wearing, you know, certain gear. So it makes me think, and yeah, him being all innuendo-y about it. And it's just like, oh, yeah, that is what's going on, isn't it? Because, yeah, we got, this place has reskinned. You know, enemies and everything. Even these guys are super strong. What the hell? She's gotta avoid the badasses. Whoops. Yeah, he's got like a police hat and it's called a banger. Okay.
Jazz, stop! Oh my god, I'm so ticklish there. Oh, did I hit the transmit button? Oh, crap! Hey, yeah. So you're still gonna try to infiltrate my palace, huh? Whoop. Death on your head and such.
Okay, sorry, I got distracted. I forgot this was a thing. A mini Steve. He even goes, hey-o. Jesus Christ. Okay. Sorry, I forgot about, like, Mini Steve. You know, they have stuff like that happen more in the second game, where they got, like, what was it? Like, Mini Looters, or whatever they're called again. And so you just, like, a variety of enemies that just, like, pop out of treasure chests. Do I want to be helping this claptrap? And did he actually just... Okay. Come on. Die. There we go. Jesus Christ. Okay. Sorry, a lot happening. I'm trying to focus and trying to commentate, and it's just like, there's so much. Okay, you. Oh, you discovered the claptrap robot has been over.
Girls of all ages like candy.
Okay, I see what they're implying there, but I don't think this. Okay, but you know, you see the joke? He's literally got a boot on him. I mean, it's kind of funny, you know, taking the repair of the claptrap mission and then, like, twisting it with a different, you know, means of it needing to be repaired. Okay, take a second. Jesus Christ. Okay, this DLC is putting me through the ringer more than I thought, and yeah, I didn't... I think I need to finish the game for this, but they're scaling up just a little bit higher than us. I don't remember if that's intentional or what. Whoops. Okay. Now that's a super fast, you know, recharge. Let's see. We knocked our cooldown by 16 seconds, so 20 seconds. And then we reduce the cooldown every 6 seconds every time we get a kill. Oh, Jesus Christ. I swear, okay. Again, I'm just trying to remember, if this is intentional, then I'll be fine with it. If it's not, I feel dumb. Okay, we've returned after a couple of hours. So, you might notice Lilith's level is a bit higher, because I had gotten so fed up, I just decided to say, to hell with it, we're just gonna start over. I'm gonna go and just finish the last couple of missions of the game, get a few level ups from that, even did some of the DLC. I beat Island of Dr. Ned with Lilith, and now, well, enemies are still high, but we're over level a little bit over. So, bleh. We got some better equipment, not much, I'm still using the same Hellfire thing I was using, but I got other better equipment, and boy, getting back to this point was super easy when your level is way higher. So, I feel so dumb, because I thought I was trying to cut corners, not that it took me that long. I could have beaten the base game and then done this, and I would have been fine. And, you know, doing the last couple of missions I needed for Lilith, that took me 40 minutes. It took me as long as it took for the Game Grumps video I had in the background to play, and that was, you know, the Ace Attorney video, or they're playing Ace Attorney 2, and they finished up Turnabout, I forget what the second case of the second game is called. They're done with the case, and now they're going to Turnabout Big Top next time. So, it didn't take me long to finish the game, and then I decided to go for it, and then did a lot of missions, do almost all of Dr. Zed. The only thing I'm missing is this final side quest, which I just didn't want to bother with. I just got sick of dealing with at one point. So, we're gonna keep on going. We're gonna cut through, we're gonna find Shank, we're gonna fire him up, or whatever if he's weak to fire. Otherwise, I got some very good caustic weaponry with me. So yeah, now we're fine. I feel so bad because I spent so long moping about the difficulty here and it's kind of all my fault, but Jesus Christ. I suppose, yeah, endgame content should be done for after the endgame. I don't really care about Moxie's Underdome, but Dr. Ned was pretty simple. And Moxie's Underdome was just like, well, I don't care that much. This was more brutal than I expected. But, you know, I did cut some corners, so I wasn't very well equipped to dealing with what I'm dealing with. No, not explosive. Incendiary, because that's the high level. Let's teach him a lesson! There, boy, that got solved several hours just to beat those guys very easily. Oh, shoot, I just realized. Nope. Where the heck do we go? Okay, hold on. Where's... this door supposed to open? Where the heck do we go? Was this even the main path?
Did you just kill Jerome? God, his pecs were rock hard. We used to joke that they could deflect bullets. I guess they can't. Poor Jerome. Also, I'm pretty much totally gonna kill you now, by the way.
That wasn't already on your plan? That wasn't on the docket? What the... Oh, Jesus Christ. Wait, no. We came here. Have I been getting mixed up? Oh, God damn it. This is the main path. Son of a bitch. Okay. Whatever. So I could have ignored them. I didn't pay attention to the goddamn son of a bitchin' map. God damn it. Okay, whatever. Now you're all gonna die anyways, because now I'm just not putting up with any of y'all's nonsense. I've been upgrading Lilith's, you know, damage output and fire rate, so, you know, she's just blasting everything off.
Oh man, you're dead! You're dead! Shank's gonna gut you! Shank's gonna slit your throat! Shank's gonna suck your eyeballs out of their sockets with a straw! Shank's gonna...
Shank. That's Mr. Shank.
Mr. Shank? Very gentlemanly, I was like, what's that sticking out of his head in his icon? Is that what I think it is? Yeah, it's a Shank, all right. Okay, I still don't have a very good shock weapon, as I recall. Maybe that'll do. Yeah, this relentless gnasher is amazing. Okay.
Should have got myself one of these a long time ago.
Feel my shit.
Maybe let's try.
I'm gonna kill.
Shank, you alright? You're kind of bugging out, man.
Shank! I'm over here, asshole.
If I had, you know, the electric ability, that would be very good. Am I actually married this guy? I'm just thinking about it. I can disappear too.
I'm gonna show you.
You killed my second husband. You actually killed him. I know I told you to, but I'm sorry. I need a minute. Go get the girl. I'll be in touch.
Okay. She wasn't as gung-ho about this as she first appeared to be. Hold on. Remember what I got. Corrosive contact. Yeah, corrosive contact. We're gonna need that. Okay, boy, that would have been so much easier. Elemental effect, honestly, the elemental effect chance would be so good. All that again, resistance, because we're dealing with that. But then again, increasing the damage of our general stuff. Okay.
Keep shooting!
Gotta say, the higher the level you're playing as, the greater it feels.
Thank you.
the heck do we go? Oop. I saw the green. I was like, I saw the arrow pointing, but it's just like, where the heck is this taking me? I'm trying to aim.
Yes, feel it.
There we go. Ooh. I mean, it's a legendary shot or sniper, though. Are you serious right now? Where was I? I should probably get rid of one of these iridium weapons. I don't think it really matters which, but at the same time, I should just also go to Mad Moxie's and just like go to the. You can get rid of that. I also got a bladed equalizer. That's freaking awesome. I got that. Where did I get that? I just got that. Well, no. I got an equalizer for beating the destroyer. I think I got that just somewhere randomly dropped during Ned. Don't need that because I got a more better caustic weapon to outdo the blister. Probably should have kept that shotgun. Yeah, whatever, we don't need TK's wave anymore. I'm keeping some of these needlessly, but. I want to keep the transfusion. There we go, just got another orange weapon for what it's worth. Oh, right. Athena. Oh, snap.
Your rescue is most agreeable. Thank you. But to be honest, mostly they just wanted to do my nails and talk about boys all the time. I almost sort of liked it here. They were like the sisters I never had because Atlas duped me into killing them. Wow. That got heavy, didn't it?
It could got heavier.
Never mind. I don't have time to explain everything right now. I need the teleporter straight away. Just give me the PTD.
I was gonna say PTD. Oh, probably the portable transporter device.
Meet me back at Scooter's. Sorry, this thing only has enough juice for one. Athena out.
Alrighty then. Athena is free. Now it's your turn to get out of here alive. Athena is free. She has asked you to rendezvous at Scooter's garage at T-Bone Junction. Okay.
Sorry to be such a party shitter. Trying to make funeral plans and help you escape at the same time. My late husband's cronies will be coming after you. Just take a monster off the old pier. You'll survive the fall. Oh, and pour one out for David. I mean, Mr. Shank for me.
Sorry, Mox. I don't have as much sympathy for the guy. okay. We also gotta go get that claptrap, so how the hell do we get out of here? Because the showers... Okay. Yeah, I forgot about all, like, these very obvious, like, gay overtones in here. And that's just more... It's just like, oh, okay, so that's what's going on. It's like, why was the boss room in a shower? Well, you know. Nothing to add to that, just like, yep, that all happened, I guess. Oh my god, it's Chaz! What a... Boy, they brought that around. Sorry, Chaz. You'll be with Shank in a moment. Liquid Wrath. Ooh, a new upgraded Bone Shredder. Hell yeah! Dude, thanks, Chaz. I understand what Shank saw in you now. We'll unboot that claptrap, and I think we just quit out, and then we'll just... Oh, wait, no. Well, because while I was at Scooter's, I also got some missions.
That's what I'm talking about. This way, I've got something for you.
It's contraband.
You looking to get shot?
Oh, shut up. God, that feels satisfying. God damn it. Again, the whinging was my fault, but Jesus Christ. I thought the level requirement or recommendation was like 30.
More loot? What did I do?
Caustic shotgun. Okay. I also picked up some other missions. Sunken Sea. I mean, since we're out by the Sunken Sea, we might as well do those missions, right? Am I going the right way? Yes. Because there's also like a couple of side quests. I stopped by Scooter since, you know, you start at T-Bone Junction when you load back in. You know, I went to Scooter. He had a mission for a new vehicle. And then also there were a couple of side quests for the Sunken Sea, apparently, in the bounty board. So, let's go take a quick look around. Vehicle. We'll just take this. So what missions we got? Power Leech and Road Rage? Wait. Okay, eliminate bandit vehicles.
Get out of here.
If we're gonna do that mission, we should probably get a monster. I don't remember if we gotta come back here for whatever reason, but...
Let's get out of here.
So we just gotta destroy bandit patrols. And then these, I forgot about these drifters. Just enemies I think we only ever see, as I recall, in this DLC. We never see those again, I don't think. And they kind of remind me of, like, Jak and Daxter metalheads. Come on, where are the bandit patrols? Oop, there's one coming up behind me. Okay. At least this, you know, homing rocket makes it super easy. Oop. Okay. Like, do you really want to be doing this, man? Oh, yeah. Forgot about these guys. Yeah, forgot about the rustlers and ravagers. You know, at least this is a unique enemy type. You don't see symbiosis like this until a boss in Borderlands 2. At least I don't think. I don't recall. Okay, so whatever we're doing, we're finding a bomb. Sorry, since we're here, we'll do the missions. Oops. Oh. It's like, how do we navigate this? Later. Yeah, we'll go back to Okay. I think this is where we gotta be. And then we just gotta fight our way through, right? Maybe not. No? I don't know. Okay. Keep going, maybe. Try to navigate. Sorry for all the frustrations I've caused, doing this DLC. Oh, Christ. How the hell do we get back up there? I see the way up. Oh, that's a drifter. Yeah, sorry for the frustrations. I just go like, if I just fight off some enemies, I'll get leveled up and then I'll be on par with what I gotta fight, right? No. No, no, no. Do we gotta maybe... No, definitely not. Oop, come on. Maybe? Okay. You know what? I think I do have to fight my way through the... Okay, I think I did find the right entrance and I just backed off. That seems. There we go, there's a scaffold. We're bumbling our way through. Kill him now. I know, I'm just waiting for enemies to pop up. I suppose they're up here. Not using the Merv, I'm using the caustic because I was waiting for to use those on Crimson Lance soldiers. We're bumbling. We're getting somewhere, but we're bumbling. Come on, plunge it down. There we go. Didn't seem like it did much, but oh well. Okay, nope. Road rage. Come on, a couple more of these bandit patrols. Sorry. Come on, where are you guys? You guys are always around when I don't want you to be, and you're never around when I'm actually looking to kill ya. Nope. I saw something up on the ridge. Come on, I know you're up there. Come on down! God damn it. Anyone else? There's one. Ooh. That was fun. Someone hasn't gone down yet. Where the hell are you? Come on. Where are you guys? God damn it. I'm trying to remember if we come back here anyways, but Jesus. These guys, are they literally stuck on up there somehow? Up. Gotcha. Come on, three more. Come on. I'm trying to be efficient here. Yeah, is that guy stuck up there? I'm guessing that's what happened. That guy's stuck or something, and so it's not, you know, spawning more of them. Okay. I don't remember if we gotta come back to Sunken Sea or not, but we'll just go to T-Bone Junction, turn stuff in.
Sorry. Running back and forth.
Make sure I don't go to playthrough 2. That's just the fastest way to get home. Okay, got a couple of things to turn in. Because there was also another mission, OMG, APC. Yeah, I managed to stumble upon, like, a power core while finding my way back through the bridge to get back to the Sunken Sea. So, yeah. But with that, apparently we should be able to digistruct a new vehicle. So, that's fun. I was thinking, like, didn't we use one of those before? And apparently we do, just finally unlocked it.
Hey, I got my eye. I'll just use while you turn, man.
All right, hold on. OMG APC.
Do not worry. Pandora is the most important.
So, yeah, now we got a Lancer. This guy got a little phasey electric shooter, and we teleport out of it instead of jumping in and out.
I'm not going to waste any time. There are two objectives that must be fulfilled to destroy the armory. Number one, construct a detonator that will send a signal to the bombs stored in the Atlas Depot, activating their detonation sequence. It will require my knowledge of their computer networks to gather the pieces and construct it, so that is my mission. Number two, the access code to enter the depot was changed after I went AWOL. Acquiring the new code is your mission.
All right. Okay, another Iridium rifle. Okay, codebreaker analysis, search for Atlas facility for information on the most recent code, and the bitch's payback. This bitch's payback. Kill the Crimson Lance lieutenants. Okay.
You should kill start Kairos and Typhon. The Lance bunker to the north. If you infiltrate the base, you may be able to locate some record of the access code.
Okay.
Coming out of the dust. Nasty out there, ain't it?
Nope, trying to get into driver's seat. There we go. Okay, so where to begin? The Ridgeway. I was gonna say, are those guys that way? I think we gotta go that way again. So, If we go that way, we'll end up where we need to be, I think. Oh, Jesus Christ. Come on. Okay, yeah. This thing is clumsy, but it boosts for a long time, it looks like. And hopefully, in theory, its weaponry and armor is powerful. Weapons and armor.
Tired of shooting a carbine when you really want a rifle? Try Engorge, and you'll be firing automatically. Fully automatic. On all cylinders.
Sit rep is go. Atlas has been stockpiling weapons in a base on the far side of the Fathoms past Moxie's. This armory is the key to their invasion plan. If we destroy it, the cost to their bottom line could jeopardize their strategy. At the very least, it will buy the resistance, that is, me, time to prepare. I'll have more when you arrive. Athena, out.
Okay, so it's Athena coming in through the Atlas radio waves. Okay, go a little bit farther, try to get these, the GDs. Hold on. Okay, so we're hitting up the two people she wants us to kill up ahead, and then we'll get to the Codebreaker. Damn, there we go. You know, well, I'd say aside from the monster, but you know, we're finally getting weapons where the weaponry's worth a damn, or vehicles where the weaponry's worth a damn. You know, where was this stuff before? And the thing is, I don't think we can use these vehicles outside of the T-Bone Junction, so that sucks. Very slow vehicle, and even the boost isn't that fast, but we're getting there. Okay. Now we can GD party, because now we're 6 levels above these chumps.
Your sweet release.
Yeah, I should did this from the start. I'm sorry for wasting our time, but now we're gonna just rip through these guys. Do I have the right switch back to corrosive? Because that's usually the way to go. Oops. I was like, he's probably gonna explode. There we go. What was that? Hold on a second. Oh, for some reason I thought he dropped an orange gun. Get the hell out of here, you probes are still a pain in the ass. Okay, Commander Kairos. Okay, the Lance Assassins, which I'm starting to assume maybe I didn't kill that lady I thought I did. I think maybe something else happened. Mayhaps. Goddamn. Unless that's just his entourage. Oh. Well, that worked out. Yeah, this rocket launcher. Yeah, I also got this as part of the. The hive mind. Gonna leave a marks. I'm trying to figure out what how the reference works there, but okay. Okay, so that was the first guy. But, okay, so now we killed Minerva. That's two down. Okay, now that guy's past where we need to go. So Crowbreaker analysis there. Okay. So, but anyways, no, that hive rocket launcher is great. It fires, you know, three salvos of really strong rockets, like, back to back. That is actually how I killed Dr. Ned. I was just about to die from... I was about to die from in Fight for Your Life, and then I pulled out that rocket launcher trying to aim for a zombie, and Ned ended up popping up in front of me, and all three rockets just plastered him in the face, and he was dead. Oh, they cleared out the blockage. What? I was like, okay, it's under us, right? Damn it. Kinda got overzealous there, but... Let's take that a little slower this time. There we go.
Ice cream day! Oh snap! It's ice
cream day! Oh, that's right. I love this one.
Ice road, a la mode. Oh, I'm in the mode for ice cream day.
Oh, dear God! What was that? Oh, you were recording.
Oh, son of a! Come on! Why do they cut out like that? Okay. Hold on. No, this is funny. It's the bolts. Find the code. Hold on. Come on. Now I gotta find the damn thing. Maybe I passed it. No. I'm trying to find. Come on, this one's great. Where is it? Come on, goddammit.
Ice cream day. Oh,
okay, it's playing again.
It's ice cream day. Rocky road. A la mode. Oh, I'm in the mode for ice cream day.
Oh, dear God, what was that? Oh, you were recording that?
Dude, that is so mean. You are so mean, Derek. I am not sharing my ice cream with you. It's Rocky Road, too.
Oh, I heard. I just need the access code for today.
No, Derek. It was your day to have the access code. I'm on personal ice cream leave of absence. Code 3.5.31 in the manual clearly states...
Then where is the code?
You had it. I saw you.
Oh, no, that is bad. Oh, I screwed up big time.
Did you do, Derek?
I might have played hooky to go check out the world's largest bullet. I think I left it there.
You left the access code. Something that jeopardizes all of our lives, that's all of them, at the world's largest bullet?
Yes, correct.
I got ice cream.
So sorry, that one, if it was all heard, because the subtitles just kind of stopped working there for a second, but yeah, just...
Hey again.
Oh.
So I just got a birthday card from the Admiral.
Oh, hold on, Knox, one moment. Where the hell is it?
It's got a picture of a dragon on it that says, to my special friend on his birthday, flame on. And the dragon is lighting the candles on a cake with his firecraft. doesn't even make sense to me. It's like mowing your lawn with a nuclear weapon, and it's not even my birthday. I need to kill you so I can leave. Maybe just kill yourself, save you the trouble of me.
Yeah, I love that. He's just so fed up. I can't remember. I think it's an echo that's brought up somewhere else, but Yeah, apparently, like, the original Admiral died, and so, by succession, the role got moved over to his, like, four-year-old son or something. And so he's just like, Noxus has to deal with that. It's like, I don't get it, that this is just what my life is now, and I can't stand it.
Remember, citizens, bullets cost money and resources.
Ooh, what was that? Typhon? Okay. Hold on, sorry, I was gonna say, since we're here, sorry, just like that Crimson Lance soldier, and I'm also starting to notice, I think some of these guys are voiced by Eric Vale. I haven't checked, but that's what it sounds like. You know, Trunks from Dragon Ball Z, Ace Attorney, Phoenix Wright in the anime. Funny connection. But yeah, just like singing about ice cream, and then it's like, dude, are you serious? And then the other one who was really responsible left it at a tourist trap. So good, we had to come here anyways. Nope, not core collection. Because we gotta find that code. And now maybe we'll also be able to destroy those last couple of bandit patrols we need to destroy. Wee-oo! 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 And there it is, the world's largest bullet. I completely passed it by. Come on, I'm looking for bandit patrols instead of the stupid drifters.
Haven't you tried Engorge yet? What's stopping you? Side effects? Are a few seeping boils going to stop you from satisfying the woman you can never obtain? It's time to try Engorge! And you'll be seeping
in progress.
I got the code, Athena, it's fine.
Engorge! The only product ever to be personally endorsed by notorious ladies' man, Mr. Shank.
Yeah, so this shit is tits, guys. You should see what my bitch thinks of me now. Her name is Chasmina, and she...
My mission is accomplished. When you have the code, rendezvous at our previous location. Athena, out.
All right. No, not Blaster Seed. So we help with the yeah. Okay, hold on. Come on. Oh yeah, that's right. This thing also drops mines. I forgot, yeah, this, like, vehicle is actually designed for, like, a group of four people. One more. Come on, one more, then we can just you know... exit out and save back into scooters. There's gotta be one over here. Come on, I just need one more. Where are you? Gotcha. Okay. Ready to turn that in. Sorry, I got a Discord message is popping in from a friend, and it's just like, I feel bad for ignoring them, but just give me a couple more minutes, man, and I'll be right with you. Okay. is texting me about Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links. We both, or not Duel Links, Master Duel. We've both gotten back into that recently. We played a couple of games the other night, and that was a lot of fun. I got some new decks in mind, just building up my way to it. I'm trying to get this done. Okay, now that we destroyed all those bandits, we can turn stuff in. Turn that in. There we go. And maybe by turning in these missions to Athena, well, no, we gotta talk to her about this other thing, so, well, should be very close to the next level up.
Hi, man. What you want?
You don't need anything.
Good. You're here. This is the detonator. Time to take the fight to Atlas. I'll monitor your progress and provide support from here. Good luck.
Okay, payback is... This bitch is payback. This bitch is payback too. Kill Commander Ajax. That sounds familiar. Bridging the gap. Knox out. Find the communications from General Knox. Activate the energy bridge to reach the armory. Okay. Whoops, whoops, whoops.
Hey, Sugar. I've got another job for you.
You can go.
Stop on by.
We gotta run all the way over to Moxie's for something. Jesus. Okay. Road's End. So Road's End is that way. So on our way, we will be... Yeah. Wanted dead. That's also the Crimson Tollway. Yeah, okay. On our way, we will also run into, Deep... Oh, wait, no. The Deep Fathoms is also that way. Okay, sorry, I'm just thinking. Oh, yeah, okay, so we're on our way to go see Moxie. Okay, we'll wrap up here for right now. Next time we get to team, we'll carry on, and maybe we'll end up finishing General, or Armory of Knox? I guess we'll find out next time. I'm bumbling my way through. So, until next time, thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, like and subscribe and all that. This is Timmara, signing off. Okay, duly noted, Claptrap, one moment.